शिवसमारम्भाम् ज्ञानसम्बन्धाचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्ताम् वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। I welcome you all with my love and respects. From today, we start the Akashic readings from the cosmic archives about the important subjects of life. I wanted to say a few words about this sudden new development. Yesterday, Brahmacharis asked me, what is the difference between your regular satsang and the Akashic readings? Please understand, in regular satsang, I just utter the words what you want to listen. More sophisticated, polished, sweet to your ears, able to understand by your mind. Akashic reading is just as it is in the record, I am reading it out. In that, nobody is involved. Just the independent intelligence of the cosmos, the source of the creation, gives its expectations about your life, how the Creator feels the life should be. What for he created what he created, what for he is maintaining what he is maintaining, what for he is rejuvenating and refreshing what he is rejuvenating and refreshing. So in this nobody is involved other than the ultimate superior, the source of creation. And please understand, these readings are uneditable, unalterable. They cannot be edited, altered, manipulated. This is a command I give for the Nityananda mission, Nityananda Sangha, forever, forever. These unedited versions of the original format of these readings should be made to available to the whole world free of cost forever. Nobody has a right to comment on these readings. Nobody has a right to manipulate these readings. Nobody has a right to interpret, comment these readings. They are complete unto themselves. For anybody to live in tune with the cosmos, the Jivan Mukti, living enlightenment, does not need any special practice other than listening to these great readings again and again and again. When you listen to these great readings, naturally your negative logic is penetrated, broken, and these great truths settle in your inner space, and they make you live enlightenment. I know the power of the happening. Just now, what is happening? I thank Mahadeva for being so compassionate and graceful for offering his very book of heart to the whole world, letting all of us to read his book of heart, what he keeps in his heart as the most sacred secret knowledge. Thank you, Mahadeva, for letting all the beings to become Mahadeva. This science will make every heart which receives will become Shiva. Rishi means the person who sees the mantras. Mantra means the words which shows the path to people and liberates people towards enlightenment, shows path to the highest consciousness. I can say now starts the real Nityananda Sangha and Nityananda Mission. This Akashic readings are the beginning of Nityananda Mission, because these readings, which will go on for at least 108 days, will form the core. This will form the basis of Nityananda Sangha. From these readings, the teachings Nityananda Sangha need to teach to the world, the classes you need to conduct, the lifestyle you need to live, everything will evolve from this 108 Akashic readings. Here, I am just reading out exactly as the cosmos wants to present itself to all of us. I promise there will not be any way, even the slight interpretation, interference, commentary, pollution, contamination from my side into these readings. Without any fear or greed, the source is opening itself to the whole world. Nityananda should never be claimed as the author or speaker of these readings. It is only channeled through the body of Nityananda. Let it be clearly told to the world. Let it be on record. I am not the speaker. I am not the owner of these words. These words cannot be copyrighted. A pure, sacred secrets of the spiritual world. It is the book of heart of the cosmos. It is from the very source, the cosmic archives. Today, Bhagavan starts with the subject birth. Let him read out whatever he wants to read and utter. Then he will answer your questions also. So whatever Kalabhairava reads out in the morning will be the Shruti, the ultimate truths for life. Whatever he answers in the evening to your questions about direct day-to-day problems will be Smriti. living those great truths in your everyday situation, applying those great truths in your everyday situation. Let Mahadeva, Kala Bhairava be invoked. Shiva 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 Namah Shivaya Shivaya Namah Shivaya Namah Shiva 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 This is the readings from the Akashic records about birth. There is no such thing as birth exists. Every individual water drop in the ocean, when it moves, by its very innate intelligence, visualizes it is born and separated from the whole. When it gets rid of the very root delusion, it is called enlightenment. The birth is not happening as human beings understand as the separation from the source. The source continues to exist as part of the part which thinks it is already become part from the source. Source participates completely with the part in every action, in every deed, in every step, in every behavior, in every moment, through its all-permeating penetration, presence, the participation is never allows the separation of the part from the whole, so the part continues to be the part of the whole. The birth, as you understand, does not exist in the cosmos continuously. Your movements, your desires creates different states of consciousness in you. Because of these altered states of consciousness, like lust, anger, greed, fear, jealousy, competition, love, feeling of deprived, depression, because of these various experiences and the expressions, part starts feeling it is separated from the whole. The moment the part feels it is separated from the whole, it claims it has taken birth. So the birth actually does not happen as you think. When a body comes out of another one body, it cannot be called as birth. Only when the individual awareness feels its independent existence, the birth begins. Birth is the beginning of the suffering, as the part forgets its source existence, connection and participation with the source. As the source relationship is forgotten by the part, the deluded suffering becomes the lifestyle from the moment of the birth. Birth cannot be considered as the separation of the body you are carrying from another own body, which you call as mother, as this does not immediately inflict suffering into the individual part, because the individual part does not claim, feel, potent, participate in the concept that it is individual part. So the truth exists as it is, even though the body is separated from the another one body, which you may call as mother. The moment the individual consciousness feels the part is no more participating directly with the whole, that moment can be considered as birth. That moment indicates the individual's suffering beginning. It may get extended as long as that individual, that part, feels it is independent existence from the whole existence. When the part remains as the part, it continues to create various forms of conscious states, and the various forms of conscious states creates the kaleidoscopy experience of this world for that individual part. When the individual part realizes its mistake of remembering itself from the whole, it relaxes into the whole. That moment is called enlightenment. In this deepest form of the truth, O the souls which feels deluded, you are separated you are moved away from the whole, come back, remember, in the form of breathing, in the form of heat, in the form of your body, in the form of the thoughts penetrating into your system from the space, I, the whole, continue to hold, support, feel, be part and participate in the existence and in the part of the existence, even though the part does not feel, I am participating in your existence. I am the source, partner, part and whole of your very existence. Oh, dear souls who feel you have departed from the whole, relax from your delusion. Whatever you think as the distance between the source and you, it is just your thinking. The distance remains zero from the beginning of your journey, from and during the journey and till the end of the journey. Listen to this great sacred secret that will make you realize this great truth. Your birth has never happened as you consider your birth date. The birth is your imagination day, the day you felt you are separate from the whole. So relax from that imagination. The day is the day of your enlightenment. Whether the drop feels it is floating, swimming, drowning, dissolving or disappearing, the drop is always the part of the whole ocean. Whenever you accept the greed to experience different states of your own being, whenever you are afraid of different states of your own being, you create different states of consciousness to fulfill your fear or greed. That is what you call waking state, dream state, deep sleep state, the fourth state, and the crisscrossing of all these four states. Crisscrossing of all these four states creates 16 states, and above all, the ultimate state is Turiyadita, beyond all these four. In that, you experience you are always, you were, you are, you will be part of the whole. And this realization is a mandatory basic necessity for the every soul which started feeling out of delusion, it is separated from the whole. The birth, as you think, never happens. It is just the different states of consciousness creating the kaleidoscopic effect and showing you the universe and the world in a different space, because the kaleidoscopic effect which you create attracts your attention so much by creating fear or greed. You forget to look into the first person and see you remain, will ever remain as the part of the source, will never, can never move out of the source. The source exists in source. So where is the question of birth?
We have a few questions on birth. The first question is from Moksha Priyan from Bangalore. He is asking, "Dearest Swamiji, why did the Creator make us forget our prarabdha during the birthing process? Would life not have been more in tune with the cosmic will if everyone remembered their prarabdha? Thank you."
Creator did not even allow your birth. Your birth is your independent decision to rebel against the Creator, against the source. As your very decision to be born is against the will of the source, it is not the source which made you forget your prarabdha. It is your individual decision to deny every truth from the source. You just decided to deny the whole as completely. The part has decided to go against the whole and reject the whole completely because it is your decision to shun away from all the truths of the whole. You decided to forget your prarabdha. Your prarabdha is nothing but the quickest, easiest conscious experiences through which you can flow and reach the whole. And remember, you never were a separate part from the whole. So it is not the Creator who made you forget your prarabdha. It is your strong rebellious mind which decided to say no to the whole creation that made you forget the prarabdha. Now, the more you accept the existence as it is, the more you accept the various kaleidoscopic experiences of different consciousness happens in you as it is, you will realize your prarabdha. This is the process Mahadeva wants to initiate all of you. I tell you all, by sitting for 21 days without moving from a place and witnessing all the different states of consciousness happening in your body and mind and inner space, you reach a space where prarabdha becomes seen, perceived, experienced directly by you.
The next question is from Shrikant Gopi. He is asking, Dear Kala Bhairava, why God created this world? God disguised as human being, created suffering, tried to resolve and try to give enlightenment. All seems like a meaningless game from the highest perspective. God creates, God incarnates, God gets enlightened. What is this game about? Please clarify.
My dear son, what you described itself is an answer. Only one thing you need to understand. You need to remove that word, highest perspective. That is the only perspective. God incarnates, God gets enlightened, God plays this whole role, and God plays with himself. It is like a child playing with his own body. God is playing with his own body. It is not highest perspective. This is the only perspective. Realize that, my son, you achieve the true realization which I wanted to share with humanity.
The next question is from Ma Atma Niranjani from Chennai. She is asking, we are sending these questions as the answers to these will have a deep relevance to pregnancy care program. We would love Swamiji to speak on what happens when a pregnant lady seeks the blessings of an enlightened master. This would be of great help in bringing down enlightened souls. Thank you.
When a pregnant lady is touched by the enlightened being, the bio memories of the enlightened being gets into the body of the child in her womb. The umbilical cord is the part of the body which is built with more percentage of emotion and less percentage of flesh and blood. As this part is built with more percentage of liquid emotion, less percentage of solid flesh and blood, the energy received in our body by the blessing or the touch of an enlightened being directly goes and gets stored in the bio memory of the child. When the child's bio memory is stored with highest truth and the true remembrance of its eternal oneness with the existence, it attracts a soul which never feels itself as separate from the whole. As it never feels itself separate from the whole, the part continues to be the part of the whole, from the beginning, it does not feel separate and grows, expressing its whole consciousness as Jivan Mukta.
The next question is from Sri Nitya Jnana Prabhananda. He is asking, what is the difference between soul leaving from one body to another body by yogic powers and taking birth as a newborn baby? How a baby chooses to express his or her feelings through particular action like crying and laughing? Why should it not laugh for sorrow and cry for happiness? Thank you.
The ability to relax from the reflections of your nervous system consciously without breaking your identification with the whole is the Parakaya Siddhi, the ability to move from one body to another, the ability to move from one body to another can be used while you have one body, entering into another one body and coming back to the same body which you left. It is called Parakaya Siddhi. It is called Parakaya Pravesham. When you leave this body once for all and take another one new body and never come back to this old body again, it is conscious birth. So understand the truth about the ability to leave one body and enter into another body. The next truth you need to know, when you do not have the ability to move from one body to another body, keeping your awareness of the identity intact, even then, if you try to get rid of one body, it is called suicide. The suicide only damages your identity, breaks it into so many pieces without you becoming one with the whole. As this self-destruction causes a severe damage in the process of you becoming one with the whole, you needed to assume again and again various bodies in which the healing, the self-healing can happen, which is an antidote for the self-destruction which you did. Then after the self-healing happens, only then your journey to experience the oneness of the whole with the whole begins. So destruction of your individual body without the ability to keep the individual awareness intact is considered as sin, as it delays your journey to be with oneness of the whole.
The next question is from Janani from Singapore. She is asking, what does a conscious birth signify? Does every conscious birth child get enlightened in their birth?
Every conscious birth is beginning of enlightenment. Once the conscious birth happens, enlightenment is not a big journey. It is only a choice. So usually, all the beings with conscious birth enters into enlightenment. If not, they may choose to stay back in that very state and continue to have few more births out of their free will. But any conscious birth being is considered already on the fast track to enlightenment.
The next question is from Ma Nitya Ramya from Singapore. She is asking, Nityanandam, why does a soul take a conscious birth?
By the strong experience of disillusionment of your projection of fear or greed, when the part is strongly hit, it searches, it seeks the source to which it can unload. The strong shock or the hit it received by the disillusionment, when it turns towards the source to unload its stress and the difficulty due to the disillusionment, it suddenly remembers its source. And the moment of remembering your source and coming face to face with the whole, you remember the secret of your birth. As birth does not happen at all, the moment you remember the secret of your birth, whether you change the body or not, you are conscious birth.
The next question is from Jayalakshmi Bernard from Washington, D.C. Nityanandam, Swamiji and others have said that a soul does not enter a body until the first breath is taken at birth. But newborns are said to recognize the sound of their parents' or siblings' voices or recognize music that had been played to them in the womb. Also, when adults do therapeutic processes like rebirthing, they often remember events that happened when they were still in the womb, some trauma or stress that their parents were experiencing, or a comment that the unborn child was unwanted or a mistake, or the pleasure of being in the womb. If the unborn child is just tissue and not a being, how can it remember these things? Thank you.
The unborn's experiences in the womb are the strong part of its biomemory. When it is in the womb of the mother, it is not just bunch of tissue. It experiences the extended life of the mother, but it does not develop the individual identity, which can be the side effect of the jivatma, the individual reflection of the soul. The individual reflection of the soul itself enters only when the child comes out of mother's body. As two individual reflection of the soul cannot exist in one body, only after the separation the individual reflection starts happening in his own body. He remembers whatever was recorded in his biomemory during the period his body was existing as the extension of his mother's life. It is just exchange of life in one body. Namah Shivaya. I bless you all to experience these great truths and achieve the eternal bliss. Nityananda.
Paramahamsa Nityananda, a rare living incarnation, is named among the world's 100 most spiritually influential personalities today. Paramahamsa Nityananda has been placed alongside Dalai Lama, Nelson Mandela, Oprah Winfrey, Paulo Coelho and others by Mind, Body, Spirit, the world's top esoteric magazine from Watkins, London's oldest and largest bookstore. A yogi by birth, he has been expressing his power of enlightenment since birth. He has authored more than 500 books in Tamil and English. Translations of these books are available in 26 languages, in Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, Hindi, Sanskrit, Gujarati, Oriya, Bengali, Marathi, French, Malay, Polish, Portuguese, Italian, German, Danish, Spanish, Russian, and Chinese. He is also an exemplary speaker with over 10,000 hours of profound life solutions through his discourses. Social services such as Annadan, free medical care, free educational services with ashrams, schools, temples, hospitals established in more than 140 places around the world, offering exceptional services. A powerful spiritual healer who has healed millions of people of diseases from migraine to cancer. A Kriya Yogi who has formulated Kriyas for physical health and mental well-being, benefiting thousands. A living master who offers practical solutions for our everyday problems. He is the founder and spiritual head of Nityananda Dhyanapitam, a spiritual powerhouse who has revived the sacred Vedic tradition by establishing Vedic temples in places like Los Angeles, San Jose, Seattle, Toronto, Ohio, Oklahoma, Phoenix, St. Louis, Malaysia, Brazil, Paris, Guadeloupe, Dallas, New York, New Jersey, Atlanta, Calgary, Vancouver, Singapore, and places in India like Bengaluru, Hyderabad, Tiruvannamalai. A spiritual guru for 10 million followers, an incarnation who transmits the highest spiritual energy through initiation, a contemporary yogi who has revived the Vedic science of yoga worldwide through thousands of yoga centers, an adept in Ashtamahasiddhis, mystical yogic powers, who has effortlessly awakened the kundalini of thousands and graced them with spiritual powers, a dynamic young guru who is an inspiration for thousands of youngsters, India's most watched spiritual guru online, a beacon of spiritual light who has triumphed over the forces of religious terrorism and political persecution. Paramahamsa Nityananda is an eternal Kalpataru, blessing the world with the boons of material abundance and spiritual enlightenment. He is the 293rd pontiff of the world's most ancient Hindu organization, Madurai Adinam. Nityanandaya swagatam, anandanubhavaswadam, sarvaroganivarakam, vande papa vinashaktam. Nityanandaya swagatam, nityamuktam nirvikalpam, dhyanaloka pradipakam, vande shantamayam. Nityanandaya swagatam.